I'm trying to think of how I saw your videos. I guess I was just tuning into Comedy Central. I mean, we loved your stuff. I mean, I was like, yeah, this is my girl.
Honestly.
Like,
thank you.
If there was one life-changing experience for you, what would that be?
I ran into an old friend from when I was in Pop Warner cheerleading, and she was like, hey, I'm a Raiderette now. And I was like, no way. She was like, yeah, you should come try out. And I was like, no way. And I decided I was going to do it because I prayed about it. I was like, you know what, God? Okay, I'm going to use the Raiderettes as my sign. And if I make the squad, I'm going to do it for 1 year, and then I'm going to move to LA and I'm going to try to be an actress. And if I don't make the squad, then I'm going to take that as my sign that the entertainment industry is not for me. And I will just figure out what I'm going to do after that. I'm going to be a dog walker or massage therapist because I'm good at giving massages. So maybe I'll just do that. And so I went to the Raiderette tryouts by myself. 700 girls at this audition.
700? And
yes, honey. And we're at this like hotel, like banquet room, convention center place. And I made it to the second round and I was like, oh, okay. And then we had to learn a dance and it's like all kind of like technical dance moves that I'm not familiar with, like pirouette, spot when you turn. And I'm like, huh? Like, can I just do this? Like real aggressively, that'd be better. And I remember I was, now it's cut down to like maybe 300 girls. And I'm in this banquet room and we're all learning the choreography and the choreographer's on stage with like a little Britney Spears microphone. She's like counting it 5, 6, 7, 8, all the things. And I'm like trying my best to do it, right? And I don't have the technique down, but I'm faking it till I make it. You know what I mean? I'm like, well, let me just hair whip. Let me at least just give some attitude with it. And like, so I'm just selling it. And she comes off stage, like weaves her way through the crowd and comes up to me and she's like, clearly you have no dance training, but you have something that cannot be taught. And that was the best backhanded compliment I've ever received in my entire life, that it stuck with me all these years. I was 20 years old when she said that to me. And I was like, thank you. Like, I get what you're saying. Like, I don't have the training. I don't have the technique, but I'm going to show up and I'm going to do me. And I remember when I ended up booking the squad and they called my number. And when they called my number that I made the squad and I was going to be Oakland Raiderette, that was not my first thought. Oh my God, I'm going to be a cheerleader for the Oakland Raiders. My first thought was, I'm going to be an actress.
What an amazing life-changing experience. I mean, Brie and I talk a lot about manifestation and different things like that. And it is crazy. When you ask for a sign, it'll come. And I think what we've always tried to teach people and tell people is that even if it's not the sign where you thought you were going, it's opening up something else for you. So even if that was a no, then there's something else that you're meant to do in life. But you were meant to be an actress. And obviously we've seen you grace so many stages and sets, and you clearly, the choreographer was right. You have it. Like, you have what you can't buy or teach. It's what you're born with.
Dirty Dancing, when I saw Anjelah, and I just, as a person, and then just seeing you on the dance floor and stuff, I was like, that's my biggest competition.
Girl, you picked up the Latina and you're like,
well, not only I go, are we the Latin, like the Latinas here? Right. I go, but the way she moves her hips, like her personality, everything. I'm like, that's, she's my biggest threat.
Yeah.
You know, I was just like, shoot. Thanks, Angela, for making me a little scared.
Oh my God, I love it.